All right, and now we are on part three of Rookie Mistakes New Scuba Divers Make. Hey guys, welcome back, and if you're new here, welcome. My name's Olivia, and I'm a professional scuba diver. I make new videos every single week, so if you're interested in scuba tips, training, or travel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, and let's dive right into the video. So like I mentioned, I've already made two of these videos before, so if you haven't already, go ahead and check those out, and let's get started. Something that I see a lot of new divers do, usually when they're a little bit more on the nervous side, is constantly holding on to their low pressure inflator hose. I think this just stems from nerves and being so focused on the fact that you're breathing underwater and what's going on in front of your face that you're not paying attention to your body. But yeah, they'll just like hold on to that hose and sometimes even like clenching onto it. So the next thing that I want to talk about that I see new divers do all the time is constantly trying to deflate their BCD when they are not descending. So when you're new to diving, you haven't quite mastered your breath control. So a lot of times people keep trying to deflate that BCD and they're not sinking. And it's actually because they're holding a bunch of air in their lungs. All they know at that point is that the air in the BCD makes them descend. So they keep holding the button down and nothing is changing. So you really wanna remember that your lungs are a huge flotation device, and if you don't exhale out of your lungs, you're not going to sink. So a way to avoid that is to just look up at your low pressure inflator hose. Once you stop seeing bubbles come out of that hose, then you've released all of the air. And then remember that once air is no longer coming out of the jacket, if you continue to hold that button down, all you're really doing is letting water back in. The next thing I see with new divers a lot is free flow regulators. So they haven't quite gotten into the habit of mouthpiece down before it goes into the water, and that regulator is gonna start shooting out air and be really, really loud. So remember, in order to just avoid your regulator from free flowing, you always wanna point it down so that mouthpiece is down before it goes in the water or before you take it out of your mouth. And every once in a while, that valve can get a little bit like stuck open. So all you have to do in that instance is just smack the mouthpiece a little bit, or you can stick your finger into the mouthpiece and that will stop the free flow from happening. Another habit that I see new divers kind of struggle to pick up on is inflating the BCD when they hit the surface. You start to ascend, you get to the surface, and then I see them kind of like struggling to keep themselves up. And I oftentimes have to say, hey, inflate your BCD, inflate your BCD, inflate your BCD, or even go over to them and pump that BCD full of air so that they get nice and buoyant at the surface. So just remember that once you hit the surface, you really want to blast down on that button and get your BCD nice and filled up with air so that you're floating until the boat comes pick you up or you swim into shore or whatever the case may be. Another sign of a new diver is when the mouthpiece is like all chewed up. So this is another thing that just takes some time to getting used to, or it can be a little bit of a nervous reaction where you really bite down on that mouthpiece. So over time, you'll get more comfortable with scuba diving, which will hopefully allow you to relax your jaw a little bit so that you're not so clenched up and tight. But also it can be where you're just not used to something being in your mouth for an extended period of time, and you feel like you really gotta bite down on it in order to keep it in your mouth. And as you kind of develop your skills and over time with diving, you'll learn to just relax a little bit and not have to bite down so hard on your mouthpiece. Another way to kind of help this is just knowing that there's a bunch of different types of mouthpieces out there. There's ones with longer bite lugs that go in your mouth. You can even get ones that are molded to your teeth. All different styles, and you can kind of figure out which style of mouthpiece is most comfortable for you, which will allow you to hopefully relax your jaw a little bit while you're diving. And the last thing I want to talk about today with new divers is that they breathe really fast. So again, this is another nervous thing and just another new to diving and new to how it all works, and that's totally fine. But yeah, oftentimes I do see new divers that really have that kind of like nervous quick breathing, or very, very large breaths and very shallow exhales is another thing that I see. So you just wanna remember that you really gotta empty that lung all the way out, and then just a nice, calm, controlled, regular inhale from there. And you wanna breathe from your diaphragm and not your chest. And that'll wrap it up for today in part 3 of rookie mistakes that new scuba divers make. Again, if you haven't seen part 1 and part 2, I will link those in the description below, so feel free to check those out. And I will see you guys next time until we dive again. Bye! Please pause for the sirens outside. My goodness. We'll be right back.